idea. Room step counter might actually be getting reset in the persistent controller step event inside of probably set level vars script. So I think that's going to be under room controls. Not there, but I know it's in here somewhere. Room step. Here we go. And here. Room step counter is still here. I think what we could do instead is just go off of room seconds. No, that would not be right. Modulus. Does everyone in the team stream? So Chris streams periodically. He is the art director and the sound guy, so when he streams, he does all the pixel art, pixel for pixel. I don't think he's got to do a stream yet on the sound. And Chris, that's Chris, and Phil will probably be doing some streaming when he's working on the hardware. You want the link for the game. I'll drop this. You probably want our YouTube channel. And or Twitch for Chris. So hold on, I'll give you the Twitch one as well. Here's YouTube, and I think Chris is at and Phil. He's got something, but I don't think he has done any streams yet. But he will be, because he has got a crucial part of this. So. Yeah, Phil has not streamed anything at all yet. So, and Chris doesn't stream. You know, for a little bit there, he was streaming a little bit frequently. But no problem. But I'm hoping that he'll be able to start streaming soon here. So, oh man, this is frustrating. On this. This guy right here. So this is not. I'm gonna see this room step counter real quick. I'm gonna see if it gets reset. Set room, room step, base controller, enemy generator 2, enemy generator. Good, 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 good. Let's go look at enemy generator because it might actually get reset in the enemy generator. Just gotta check. Look here. looking to create events global. Just making sure I'm not doing something stupid like just resetting it at the very beginning of this. Init room step counter is what we're looking for. Step. And if step is greater than or equal to incremented, then it's equal to zero. So, no. The answer is no on that. However, I'm feeling like this is a little bit unreliable. I think I'll just create a counter inside of the enemy 2 generator and go off of that counter. So I'll just do counter equals 0. For now, counter and an incrementer. So instead of this, I'll change this to counter. I'll do the counter at the very beginning, and we will reset it at the end if we need to. So if counter greater than or equal to room speed times, I don't know, a minute. Just say counter equals 0 and remove the incrementer, because that at this point is not necessary. Awesome. Close that guy, not working off of him anymore. This one. Counter modulus is equal to 0. This should be 4 seconds. 4 seconds, because room speed is 60. This should be 1 second. Did you think about the Easter egg that I mentioned yesterday, or do I have to donate some money to get that Easter egg implemented? I'm trying to remember what the Easter egg was, no name. Something at the very beginning, if you destroy, I forget what it was. Explain it one more time. And you'll have to convince Chris, who I think is in here. Chris, are you still in here? Sky Cursor. To implement it. Tom Cruise Danger Zone. Yeah. Chris is the one with the final say on it, so I always let him make the call on it. Oh, yeah. Chris, you watched it. You heard it. So, no name, have at trying to convince Chris. Go for it. All right. Four seconds here, 1 second there. Counter, plus, modulus, hella good counter, modulus. I think this might work now. Let's see if we can tell much of a difference between the... Oh, I'm also wondering if that... No. Let's just sit and see if this works. Catch up with me here, Game Maker. At dusk. Go. Slow, man, slow. What the heck? Right. These guys, 1, 2, 3, a 4 second delay is not real, man. Look, these guys are right next to each other. I've done these delays so many times, I don't know what the problem is with this one delay. So we got one at that point. Create a second one, we got two. Create a third one, we got three. If it's three right here, then modulus equals the room speed times three. In other words, 60 times four, which is 240. Chandu16, thank you for the follow. Very much appreciate the support. All right, so room speed times four right here. I'm gonna go like this. Bar. The whole sequence could be at just a few seconds total, so those helis can zoom by pretty quick. Okay, gotcha, Chris. I'll make them a little bit faster. They have to be going slower than the road.
Sky Mission 1, Death at Dusk.
And the other thing is, seeing if this worked. Nope. Delay. Broken. Blowing my mind here. Controller room level 2.IVC is equal to true and counter modulus is equal to 0. The whole sequence to the intro stage should only take a few seconds, then right into action. No, I agree, man. I know. What seems to be happening is almost like the heli counter is activating, like they should be. Let me just look at this sequence one more time, because the helis should almost be coming on screen as soon as those army trucks are on screen, and I feel like they're not, so I think there's an issue. I'm gonna go look at the sprite width on the heli. Enemies, level 2. Heli Wolf. Sprite width is actually 140. So yeah, he appears just off screen.
Mission 1, Death at Dusk.
Go. So really, they should be coming on screen like right now, but they're not. Look how long it takes them to come on screen. The other thing is, I know there's a problem with their positioning. The X position is not going to be right here, so it's going to be 140. I'm going to say minus the object ellie_wolf.sprite X offset. I think that'll be correct. This may not work if I don't have object ellie wolf, but I think it should just because I'm calling it directly. This is not working though. Counter modulus is equal to zero. It's obviously working for like 1 second gap. My goodness. I need to do a show debug message. Show debug message. And we'll say 4 seconds. And that'll probably fire several times as long as it's waiting to increment the counter. This is 1 second. And right here we'll say show debug message fire instance create heli. So we should basically see. Man, I don't necessarily want to fire one of these every single, you know, basically 60 in between each one. But let's see. We should have a big gap of those 4 second debug messages in between the third and the fourth heli. Cut the helis just a thought, or just have a few, like two or three. Yeah, I think if I can get this to work, man, it's going to look good. So give me just a second here.
Mission 1. Death at dusk. Go!
When in the world? Index object code wolf. So it is having a problem with the sprite X offset. Let me think about that. Okay, we'll get it this way. Sprite get X offset sprite heli wolf. So to answer your question, no name, I'm trying to put a gap in between the helis. I've got 6 helis coming on screen, and I'm trying to put like a 3 or 4 second gap in between them. But obviously, there's only like a 1 second gap literally each time in between them. So, not sure why it's not receiving my input well, but I'm just now doing some debugging. So, we should see some of that debugging when we get out of the game.
Mission 1. Death at dusk. Go!
Must have messed up the name of that. Copy report. Ah, just Heli Wolf. didn't name those. It's similar to what I named everything else. Going to update that right now. Sprite. Ellie Wolf prop. Should fix itself, and the objects should automatically fix themselves when I change an asset name. For the refresh here.
Mission 1, Death at Dusk. Go!
Look at that. No freaking gap. That's not 4 seconds right there. That is not 4 seconds. Man. So they're all here. Let's look at this. So, create heli. Look at that. There's a 4 second one that lasted for 1 second. Look. 4 seconds. That's 60 calls right there. Same gap as everything else. Oh my gosh, you gotta be kidding me. So waiting, and then all of a sudden the first one, 60 seconds. 60 seconds, boom, 60 seconds. And that's not how I have it set up. So for whatever reason, this is overwriting this, or this is never evaluating to true. Which we did see it evaluate to true because we saw 4 seconds here. I wonder if it's possible that something that's divisible by 1 is also divisible by 4, and I think that's probably what's happening at the instant that that comes out. So I gotta be a little bit more creative here. I mean, that's got to be what's happening. So I can do one of two things here, and I'm debating on what to do. Okay, I think I have a solution. That should do it. Let's try that. So I basically reset the heli counter, and I was actually thinking about maybe doing one other thing, which is using a completely different counter right there. Designs.
Sky Cursor.
Hi.
Mission 1.
What are you working on? Frictional design.
Go.
Thank you. Oh, look at that. There's a 4-second gap. What I'm talking about. Okay. Now to kind of do what Chris was talking about. Gonna have to speed everything up a little bit. Quite a bit. That's fine, man. Yeah, I mean, it's a development channel. I understand. A lot of game developers or web developers, no worries. Alright, so I like that. It worked. I'm going to try to leave that alone and see if we can ride with that. And okay, so if we're going to speed everything up, what is the speed of the vehicles going the other way going to be? That would be done. That would be handled in the controller. Obstacles, and probably here. Obstacles gen. Nope. Actually, it's probably here. Step. And so we're gonna speed everything. Okay. Vehicle speed is 1. So, who's deleting his messages? Is it just Nightbot? I don't think I have a mod in here deleting his messages. Okay, cool. I don't think so. Yeah, sorry, man. Maybe see if you can get No Name's Skype or private message him and see if you can... yeah, and see if you guys can Skype each other. Alright. So I think I'm going to make this speed a little bit faster. Army trucks and everything will go, let's say, 4. Let's make this guy go 4. Let's make the helicopters go a different speed, and they're going to go right here. I probably should put these guys under obstacles, but this is fine for now. Speed is here. Let's change these to 3. This should make them go by considerably faster, but not faster than the vehicles going by.
Mission 1, Death at Dusk. Go!
Why are these guys going so fast? These guys should not be going speed up as fast as they are. They're going faster than the helicopters. Plus now we gotta reduce the helicopter delay, so let's deal with that really quick. So this delay will go from, instead of take this down to 2 seconds and take this down to half a second. Room speed divided by 2. Seconds. All right. Thumbs up there. And why were those emergency vehicles going way faster? That's what I gotta figure out. Set to 4. And another follow. Frictional Designs, thank you for the follow. Appreciate it, man. Alright. Close this guy. And I think we've got a problem with up and check this guy. So there is one thing that's occurring here that I gotta fix, because I think this is affecting my emergency vehicles. So I think it would be, I'm in controllers, I need to be in obstacles, base vehicle step, and yeah, it'll be, first things first, let's add the emergency vehicles, object, ambulance, object, Car police. Thumbs up. We've got an end step event. Just fine. And the vehicle collision event. So we need to add this to the other two vehicles. Object ambulance. And object. Got another follow. Awesome size 64. How's it going, man? Thank you for the follow. Ambulance, car, police. Thank you for the support. Also, just a heads up, no name. For future reference, I think you can just direct message someone, so you don't have to give away your Skype name on chat. So, just FYI. Object ambulance, object car police, object army truck. So that should fix the collision problem, and they should not be trying to outrun each other. I don't mind if you give it away on chat. I'm just saying, like, for your benefit.
Mission 1, Death at Dusk. Go!
Okay, so much better, but the police cars are going. The emergency vehicles are still going faster. I must not have gotten everything correctly. Here we are. I see. VAR emergency vehicle. False. We'll do another case here. Object, ambulance, brake. Case, object, car, police, emergency vehicle, false, true. And then if army truck or emergency vehicle, and then we got to make sure that emergency vehicle has an original speed, and I think it does. So actually, let's go see what army truck is doing in terms of I think we're doing something specific here. Facing right, HP. Here we go. I'm just gonna copy this over to the other two. The ambulance add event step event. Control action drop. Thumbs up. Create. What do we have here? Create event. Event inherited. Cool. And let me just make sure original speed is in base vehicle so that I don't get an error. Of course, it's in base vehicle init. So, army truck, do you set original speed? No? Where are we setting original speed at? It's gotta be in that script. Yeah. Army truck. Man, where is that? I'm gonna just drop this in both of these real quick though. Add event, step, control here. Yeah, do the event inherited. Actually, I think I'll just be good if I drop it right there and make sure I inherit event in both of these. This guy's inheriting. Yes, he is. And this guy's inheriting. No, he's not. Event inherited. Okay. Thumbs up. Play. All right. Thanks a lot, Chris, man. Talk to you soon, bro. Also going to fix this one more time. I got one more fix to make to this. Close this guy. Game Maker just failed on me. Again, I gotta make sure that's saved for these vehicles. Did it save? Shit. Step event, step, control, drop. Event inherited. Just copy all this. Okay, car police. Add event, step. Control. Boom. Done. And that's probably good, but we gotta fix this controller. going to be under scripts, controllers, obstacles. Actually, there's an enemy generator controller that I need to handle. Step event. Haven't moved these to script yet, which I normally like to do. Also, I can remove these debug messages now that we got it working. Additionally, let's change this to half, which would be 1, and actually change this to 4, which would be 0.25. This would be 1 second. So, just make the gap even smaller. So, let's try this one more time. Now, the police cars, if I did this correctly and I don't get an error, the police cars and the ambulances should go by a little bit faster than the helis do. Of course, remember though, the helis come on screen as soon as the army trucks come on screen, so it'll be close to see which one finishes first here. So, compiling. Waiting for a compile. And since I just had to restart, or since my game maker either crashed or just didn't know what I was doing, basically I have to wait for the first compile again, which can be up to a minute.
Mission 1, Death at Dusk. Go!
Oh yeah, that's pretty good. Pretty freaking good. Now these need to speed up in terms of how fast those are fired. And those are going to be a little bit simpler. Controllers, obstacles, step, and we've got a modulus that we're controlling here, but we're doing that in the helper. And so modulus is normally 3 steps, or yeah, 3 steps, and it evaluates to 0. But in this case, we're going every half second. So we're going to make this as quick as the other one. And let's make it make it a little bit quicker even than the difference of the helis.
Mission 1, Death at Dusk. Go!
These trucks, man, these trucks. Okay, so we're gonna make those way quicker as well. So this will be like 1.5 up to like 3 seconds. This will be like 2 up to like that's 1.5 seconds. Make this 3. Make this 1.5 seconds, and also make these. Come in at like 3.5 seconds. And I gotta make sure the speed is correct here. The wolf is going to go across the screen at 1.5 seconds. Cool, should be a little bit slower. Let's try that though.
Mission 1, Death at Dusk. Go!
Love it. And then I'll kill, I'll cut all these guys off. That's much, much, much better, cleaner. It's pretty quick. Could maybe be just a tad bit quicker. I gotta see what the speed of that road is going by. Specifically any of the controllers again. Hit the background controller for level 2. What is the speed of the road? Background level 2 init. Okay, go there. Speed of the road is going by at 7. So we could literally make everything look like it's going by even faster by increasing that a little bit. But I think we can say that we could make everything on the ground go by pretty quick even still, even quicker than what it is going by. I don't think it should even, they should even be going as quick as they are right now, so I'm going to fix that first. Talking obstacles and step changes from 4. It could go all the way up to like 6. I think that's what I'll do since they're not flying. And I'll make the so they'll go by pretty quick there, but there may be a lot of gaps in them. We'll just see how that looks. And the enemy generator, we can make these go faster now. So this guy will be, instead of 3, we put it up to 6 on the other one, let's say 4.5, let's see how fast that is.
Mission 1, Death at Dusk. Go!
Okay. So that looked really freaking good. This guy I'm actually going to take down to room speed divided by 2, so a half a second, since they're going by so quick now. And I might even be able to take down these other ones. Were still gapped kind of far apart based on that. I'm going to take this down a little bit more, so 5, so that'd be 5. Alright, see you, no name. Take it easy, man. Alright, this may be my last test here, guys. I'm gonna try this.
Mission 1, Death at Dusk. Go!
Look at that one more time.
Mission 1, Death at Dusk. Go!
Yeah, I like that on the choppers.
Mission 2.
sometime.
Mission 1. Death at dusk. Go!
And then go 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, boom. First enemy. Yeah, that would probably be pretty good timing. So I say we're in a good spot there. Ah, man, that was really tough, actually. About where it needed to be. I'm sure there will be a lot of tweaks. We'll do a lot of tweaks to that to make it look even better. But for now, that'll be good. So I think that's going to be it for today's stream, guys. This has been, of course, Skycursor Daily number 46. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you for the follows. Thank you for the support. I appreciate you guys, and I appreciate the chat and the activity in the chat. So thanks a lot, guys. So as is customary for the end of stream, I'll go ahead and play our outro video. And I will leave you guys with that. Thanks again, guys. I really appreciate it, and I will talk to you soon.